Hi guys, and welcome to another feedback sessions. So today I'm going to be listening to more of your tracks, and I'm going to be giving some feedback on it, give my opinion for what it's worth. So we'll just jump straight into this. So the first track is called Neon Galaxies. Okay, so some really nice sounds in there, really well put together track. The drums sit really well in the mix. I really like the sort of towards the end of about 3 minutes. I really like the chord progressions and the leads and stuff that are used. So really, really well done on that track. So the next track is called Neon Summers. Seems to have a bit of a neon theme going today. This is called Neon Summers Reception. Okay, a real nice track again, some great melodies in there. What I would say though is there's a little bit too much reverb on the snare. I would also say that the track's over-compressed as well. I think it's very, very over-compressed. And some of the leads as well. About 1 minute, about 2 minutes. There's a really, really piercing lead that's really high, so I'd bring that back in volume. And I'll look to dial back your limiter or compression. If you're using FL Studio and you're using stuff likes of Maximus and the limiter to master, that can really, really distort stuff. So I'll really, really bring that back. If you are using that, I would use it very, very subtly. But that's what it sort of sounds like in the mix. It's very distorted. And a lot of levels are crashing. So just dial everything back in the mix a little bit. Sometimes, even though it's a bit quieter, it'll sound a lot clearer. So next track is called Spaceram, VHS Heroes. Now, he said in the email that he doesn't really have a name for his synthwave project yet. The link that he gave me to his SoundCloud has sort of all sorts of stuff on there. But it's just starting a synthwave project, so I'll quickly run through this track. Thank you. Again, that is a really, really nice track. Really well put together, really well produced. Everything sits nicely in the mix. Some great leads and some great sounds in there. Love all the drums and stuff, and you know the additional stuff you've added in. It's a really, really nice track. Really top track. There's not a lot that I can really say that to improve that. I think it's spot on. So congratulations, well done. Great track. So the next track is called Soul Survivor. Really nice track again. One thing I would say is the bass seems a little loud, so maybe bring that back a touch in the mix. Really nice chord progression there as well. It sounds like Keep Me Hanging On by Kim Wilde and Safri Duo Bongo Song. Really famous chord progression there, but some really nice leads. Love the melodies, repeating melodies. It's going right through the track. The only thing, I would say is the bass would need change slightly. Bring it down a little bit in the mix. So the next track is called Whytee, 88 BPH. Thank you. Okay, so great track there. Some of the sounds I recognise. I think I've actually used one of the sounds in there on one of my tracks for one of my latest albums there. Sounds like it's the M1. Nice track. I would say it's sort of very minimalistic. You've got some great sounds in there, but you just need something to tie it together a little bit more. Maybe a pad or maybe a pedal, like a repeating pedal noise that's playing sort of the same note over and over just in the mix, or even strings, or just something like that, just to give it a bit more for the listener to hear, rather than just the certain elements, because you can really pick out the elements in the track, so you need someone to sort of blend them together. But apart from that, it's a really nice track. Well done. So the next track is called Neon Sword Theme. Okay, so nice track there. I think this was one of the tracks that was, I think the guy said it was for a video game or a computer game, and it was sort of looking at the sort of spy theme. So I think you've really nailed it there. Some really nice sounds in the mix there. Really like the melodies, although you say the melodies aren't really synthwave, they sound really, really good in the mix. I think you've nailed that, and the sounds that you've chose to go with the melodies is really, really good as well. Okay, so jump straight into the next track now.
Thank you.
Okay, so another really, really nice track. Reminds me a lot of sort of the Miami Nights sort of sound. One thing I would say is the bass maybe needs, the notes are too long. I would maybe change the notes or even the release on the notes just to make it a bit more tighter in the mix. And there is a lead that comes in about 3 minutes. It's pretty loud. It's not loud in the mix. It's loud because of the sort of sound. So I would maybe look at EQing that. Or maybe look at cutting some of the low end and some of the low mids off that as well, just to make it punch through a bit more, because I think it's interfering with the other sounds in the track. But apart from that, a really, really nice track. So next track is by Dank and Grody. It's called, or Grody, it's called Tubular Frequencies. Sounds in there as well, some really, really iconic 80s sounds. It has a real 80s feel to it. It's a really nice track that progresses very well in, you know, as it's going along. Some of the leads there are a little quiet in the mix, but I think that's because the bass and the kick are very, very loud in the mix. Well, not so much the kick as the bass is very loud and distorted. I'm not sure if that's the sort of sound you're going for, because I know the likes of Carpenter Brut and stuff like that has that sort of crunchy, distorted bass. But that's more on the sort of dark synth, and this to me doesn't really sound dark synthy. It's more of a, you know, more upbeat synthwave sort of music, this. But again, it's a really nice track, so maybe if that's what you're going for, the sort of crunchy sound, you've nailed it. If not, I would maybe dial it back a little bit in the mix, bring it down a little bit, and let the leads shine through more, because like I said, they're lost in the mix over the bass, and some of the leads are really top notch. Okay, so next track has been sent in. It's just called 80s Love Theme. There's no social media links or name or anything like that, so I'm sure you know who you are if it's your track. Okay, so I'm really liking the drums in this track. I would say that maybe they're a little slightly bit too loud, maybe bring them back a little bit. But you've got some great sounds in there as well. One thing I would say, though, is the sort of... It's like a future house sort of sound. It's like a repeating sound that you can hear it at like 120. I'll maybe dial that back a little bit, or even change the instrument in the mix to something else, because it's sort of standing out above everything else in the mix. But again, you've got some really nice sounds in there. It's a really nice track. Look forward to hearing the finished version. Okay guys, so that about sums up for this video. So if your track's not featured, like I said, I've ripped back to a few people and a few of the links have expired because it's been quite a while, but I have ripped back to yous all. If you feel free to send more stuff in. Again, I'm getting a lot of people saying that I hope it's not too late or anything like that. It's not going to be too late, because I'm going to keep this running for as long as you are sending tracks in. I'll keep doing these types of videos. So that's about it, guys. Thanks for watching.